Welcome to our online circuit service for this Sunday, the 30th of January. Our preacher today is the Reverend Emma Morgan, and I know that she's going to be preaching on 1 Corinthians 13, and she's let me into a secret that the title of her sermon is Mirror, Mirror. So I'm assuming that she's talking about seeing through a mirror darkly. It's a wonderful topic, a wonderful purple passage of scripture. And so welcome to this service. Let's begin our service with prayer. Let's pray. Gracious God, our Heavenly Father, we come to worship you. We come to give you thanks and praise for all of your goodness to us. And Lord, as we come to worship you, we acknowledge that we do not have all the facts at our disposal. We do see some matters of theology as through a dark mirror, that we get glimpses of truths. But Father, one truth we know completely and utterly, and that is of your great love for each one of us. That you love us so much that you send Jesus in order that we could be drawn into a living relationship with you. A love that is so wonderful that nothing can ever get in the way of it. Nothing at all. And Paul lists a great list of things that people might imagine could get in the way of that love. Nakedness, famine, danger, sword, even death. But nothing can separate us from the love of God that's been revealed to us in Christ Jesus. And we know that for a wonderful fact. And because of that, we come to worship you. We come to praise your name. We come to remember the great things that you have done, are doing, and will do for us. And so we come to worship you, to bless you, and to praise you. And Father, although we're doing that today in this online service, in a way that has perhaps become a new normal to us, but very different from that which we've been used to over the years, Father, we thank you that we can still, in the comfort of our own homes, praise you and worship you and give you thanks. But Lord, we also say sorry. Sorry for the things that we do that are wrong. Sorry for the things that we fail to do that you would have had us do. And Lord, as we bow before you in this moment, we ask for your peace, for your blessing, and to know that you speak those comfortable words to each one of us who turns to you asking for forgiveness as you say, peace. Your sins are forgiven. Thanks be to God. And so we're going to join together in the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples as we say together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Amen. I pray that God really blesses you through the rest of the service and that you enjoy what Emma has to say in a little while. God bless.
Thank you. 1 Corinthians chapter 13. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patience. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now, we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now, faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love.
Thank you. mirror, mirror. So verse 12 from Paul's 13th chapter of his first letter to the people of Corinth says, "For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love." Mirror, mirror, orbiting in space, how long must we wait to see what you face? Orbiting 1.5 million kilometres from Earth, will you discover anything of creation's birth? Echoes of the rhyme written by the Brothers Grimm, in their tale from folklore, we may know as Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. A mirror has been used in many stories, and a good number of stories have become movies where a special mirror is spoken to, as it holds knowledge. Knowledge of the past, knowledge of the present, and knowledge of the future dependent upon the present choices. Mirror, mirror, Snow White and the Huntsman, and Harry Potter are films I particularly think of alongside the Disney movie Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. The stories offer insights into relationships, the struggle for power, the influence of light in the darkness, the power of love and forgiveness, the positive outcomes through faith, hope, and love. The James Webb Space Telescope, or Webb, has taken 20 years to build and was finally launched into space from a tropical rainforest near Kourou, French Guiana, a place near the equator, so that the launch vehicle Ariane 5 might benefit from an extra push due to the spin of the Earth. Some key facts about Webb. Launch day was Christmas Day, December the 25th, 2021. The journey to its orbital space, some 1.5 million kilometres from Earth, L2, is 29 days. As I record this message, the telescope is still deploying. It was folded inside the launch rocket, so needs to unfold to be ready to undertake its mission. It's possible to follow where it is on a timeline online. But the sun shield is unfolded, the sun shield being its protective sun hat. And by now the secondary mirror, primary mirror, and mirror segments will now be fully deployed, having come together like a jigsaw. The mirror segments are hexagons which will join perfectly and coated in gold, allowing infrared light to be reflected, allowing the mirror to see through dust clouds. Webb is approximately the length of a tennis court and the height of a three-story building. What key facts would you choose to share about yourself? Our launch pad, our place and date of birth, where some of us have lengthy stories about our date of birth, the day we were born, others of us very little. Maybe for some the stories are very emotional, and others of you may just be finding out. But since that date, we are on deployment. We can draw a timeline and place on it significant events. For each of us, our timeline will be unique. Perhaps you have some events or goals, future goals, to aspire to. I wonder if your life mirrors that of someone else. What do you see when you look in the mirror? For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love. As well as some key facts Webb has, according to the NASA website, it has mission goals, which it expects will take 5 to 10 years. And the mission goals are to search for the first galaxies or luminous objects formed after the Big Bang, determine how galaxies evolved from their formation until now, Observe the formation of stars from the first stages to the formation of planetary systems. Measure the physical and chemical properties of planetary systems, including our own solar system, and investigate the potential for life in those systems. And instruments: near-infrared camera, a near-infrared spectrograph, mid-infrared instrument, fine guidance sensors, near-infrared imager and slitless spectrograph. And finally, major innovations: lightweight optics, deployable sunshield, folding segmented mirror, improved detectors, cryogenic actuators and mirror control, micro shutters. For some of you, you will understand all of that perfectly. Others of us are glad to understand enough to know what this telescope is seeking to do. But how are you faring with any mission goals you set yourself for 2022? Have you set one personal goal that is achievable in 2022? Any which you are aware realistically may well take 5 to 10 years to complete. Webb offers to us parallels for church, because as church we have key facts. We have mission goals, our church's mission statements reflecting our mission goals through our calling: worship, learning and caring, service and evangelism. We have instruments, people, you and me, offering an eclectic mix of wonderful gifts and graces, reflecting the fruit of the Spirit and the gifts of the Spirit, because of faith, hope and love. Major innovations, those things church does through vision, prayer, stepping out in faith, perseverance, because we have faith, hope and love in Jesus. What do we see? What we see in a mirror dimly, we see face to face, as the light of Christ shines on us and is reflected to others as a taste of heaven on earth, because we are close to God and God is close to us. The team behind Webb are hoping to gain answers to creation. The mirrors will help the telescope see by collecting and focusing light from distant stars. How stars are formed? How did the first galaxies form, and is there life beyond Earth? They don't want to be looking dimly through the mirror, but clearly. Webb offers hope for answers. They have faith in Webb that it will achieve its mission goals. Those who study and work in the area of astronomy, I'm sure, would say they love it. Do you know enough about Jesus to have faith in him, hope in him, and love for him, because Jesus loves you, has hopes for you, and has faith in you, and that you can be and are one of his instruments and a major innovator? As church, do you look to Jesus with faith in him, hope in him, and love for him, believing he will lead you through and achieve your mission goals? Do you believe you are the instruments through which successful innovations can be achieved, because you are the light of Christ? What do you see in the mirror? Do you see dimly or clearly? In the 2012 film version of the Grimm's fairy tale renamed Mirror, Mirror, the wicked queen Clementiana, played by Julia Roberts, has a mirror house in which lives her reflection, the Mirror Queen. The Mirror Queen is younger, kinder and wiser than her true self. Her reflection is the person she could be. Queen Clementiana is reminded her choices will have consequences. The hope remained in astronomy that Webb will bring clarity to many unanswered questions. I wonder what others see when they look at us. I wonder what reflection of Jesus we give. Whilst we may feel we currently look through a mirror dimly, let us remain firm in Jesus through faith, hope and love. We have key facts, mission goals, we're the instruments and major innovators that will as the light of Christ shines on us and is reflected out to others, offer a mirror to life in Jesus Christ. I wonder whether what is reflected is the true self or the mirror image. I wonder as church whether we reflect what is true or a mirror image. My hope that is what is seen is my true self, and our churches are true to where we are with and in Christ Jesus, our Lord, Saviour and Redeemer, in whom we have faith, hope and love. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope and love abide, and the greatest of these is love. Amen.
Together. Heavenly Father, we're in awe and wonder of you. You are our Lord. It is written in your word for us to pray for men everywhere and for all those in authority. Lord, we can never put the TV or radio on without hearing some devastating news somewhere. We bring our intercessory prayer for this land and its troubles. Lord, as this nation of Great Britain, England, Scotland and Wales and Northern Ireland, we're in a sad state of affairs. We repent and ask your forgiveness for all our sins. Lord, we've gone our own way. We have disobeyed you. We have sinned. Please forgive us. We repent. Lord, we plead the blood of Jesus over each man, woman and child. We ask for the precious blood of Jesus to cover the sin in this land. Thank you for your grace and your mercy and your forgiveness. Father, we bring before you our Prime Minister. You love him and know all about him. We ask you to bless him with your divine wisdom, that he would make the right decisions for the long term and for the good of this nation and for generations to come. Please give him your strategies and give him success. We also ask for your divine wisdom for those in the United Kingdom negotiating teams regarding international trade and security. We ask for your peace to be with Queen Elizabeth and her household. We close the door to the enemy and ask for your shield of protection upon this land that we love. We plead the blood of Jesus. We resist the enemy and close the door to him. Lord, would you take the veil of the eyes of our understanding by the power of your Holy Spirit. Send spiritual awakening. We speak in the name of Jesus. We cancel every spirit of oppression, every spirit of depression, every spirit of mental illness and every spirit of suicide. We claim that every curse is broken and reversed. It is written in Psalm 91. When we're under your care, you save us from the deadly pestilence and this COVID virus. Please, Lord, heal and restore us. Lord, we ask you to activate your word of healing and deliverance in your name. We thank you, Father, for your unfailing love and your concern in the answers to our prayers. We choose life and blessings. May your will be done and your kingdom come. Now, Lord, we claim our freedom, liberty and deliverance. Release all the stored up blessings that have been held back in our lives from generations before us. You are Jehovah Jireh, our provider. You are Jehovah Rophi, our healer. You are Jehovah Rohi, our guide and our leader. Father, you go before us with a banner. You are our protector and our shield. We choose today to walk in your light. Thank you for your love and your goodness. Through the blood of Jesus Christ, we say we love you, Lord, and we praise your holy name. We glorify you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen, and amen. The joy of praying with others. To be a mat carrier. The joy of praying with others is having intercessors join you. Will you come with me into a family's living room 2,000 years ago? It is written in Mark chapter 2, verses 2 to 11. Jesus was teaching and healing in a family's living room. So many gathered there that there was no room left, not even outside the door. Four men came bringing to Jesus their paralyzed friend. They could not get him to Jesus because of the crowd. They made an opening in the roof above Jesus and after digging through it, lowered the mat the paralyzed man was lying on. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralyzed man, "Son, your sins have been forgiven." He continued, "So you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins. I tell you, get up, take your mat, and go home." Four men took their sick friend to Jesus. They just knew that if they could get to him, Jesus would heal him. Even the crowd didn't deter them. They had the audacity to climb on the top of another man's house, dig a hole in his roof, so that they could lower their friend in front of Jesus. These men took an impossible situation and brought it face to face to Jesus, who made the impossible possible. The four men peering down through the hole in the roof anticipating a miracle. Jesus looks up at them and tells them because of their faith, he would heal their friend. The men's faith, not the sick fellow's faith, brought about the miracle. Intercessors, you and I, are like those four men. They each take a corner of the mat and lower their loved ones, one at a time, to Jesus. Many of our loved ones are paralyzed by sin, rebellion, indifference, or dead in their faith. But they have no defense against you and I putting them on the mat of prayer. One of the greatest joys for an intercessor is to pray for the salvation of others. Let us bring our loved ones to the Lord right now. Father, we bring our loved ones before you. May their hearts be receptive, their spiritual eyes would be open, that they would be delivered from the power and persuasion of the evil one. Then they would repent and accept you, Lord Jesus, as their Saviour and Lord. Jesus, we praise you and thank you that you paid a high price to call us your own. Thank you, Lord, that you loved us so much that you were willing to die to give us eternal life. And we praise you, Lord. It is written in Acts 26, verse 18. Lord, open our loved ones' eyes and turn them from darkness to light, and from the power of Satan to God, so that they may receive forgiveness of sins and a place amongst those who are sanctified by faith in Jesus. Father, right now we're calling our family members, including our children and grandchildren, to salvation and wholeness. We command every influence from the enemy to be broken and severed through the precious blood of Jesus. We claim their souls, we claim their hearts for you. Holy Spirit, draw them back to you. They will bow the knee to Jesus. They will hear the name of Jesus. They will choose to obey and come into the Father's house. We take dominion over every strategy of the enemy to keep them blind to the truth. We say they're coming to the Father's house. Dear Holy Spirit, would you draw them, woo them, convict them, love them into your Father's house. Arrange situations. Give them dreams, send labourers to share the love of Jesus. Father, release your Spirit upon the hearts and minds of our loved ones. Where there was hatred, Father, replace it with love. Where there is rebellion, Father, replace it with submission. Where there's been sin and iniquity, replace them with wholeness and purity. Where there's been unrighteousness, Father, replace it with integrity, honesty and pure thoughts of you. Where there's been doubt and fear, Father, replace them with faith, hope, and loving thoughts of you. We plead the precious blood of Jesus upon our loved ones for protection. Thank you that you've heard each one of our prayers. We praise you and thank you, Lord, for your grace and mercy offered each one. Jesus, we honour you. Thanks be to God. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. And amen. I'd like to speak a blessing over our circuit. Heavenly Father, we take upon ourselves the mantle of authority that Jesus delegates to us. In his name we speak life and blessings to every household in the circuit and here in Sherburn Village. We bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus. We bless your marriages, that they may be strong and whole. We bless the relationship between each husband and wife, that it may be loving, forgiving, merciful and strong. We bless every relationship within each household, that there may be peace, love and understanding flowing between each one. We bless your health, that you may be strong and well. In Jesus' name, we resist any sickness, disease or the COVID which seeks to invade this land. To every person, we say, be well, be strong, be healthy. To any who are sick right now, we say, we bless you in Jesus' name with a speedy recovery. We speak abundant life, peace and blessing to Reverend Graham and Reverend Emma. By Jesus' stripes, you are healed. We speak protection over every doctor, nurse and health worker. May the Lord sustain you and keep you and your household safe and well. We bless your wealth, that you may have plenty to replace poverty. We bless you to have enough to live and enough to give. We bless the work of your hands, that whatever you turn your hand to may be good and profitable. We bless your business, shops, factories and every wholesome enterprise, that it may prosper and be successful. We bless the land, the grass of the fields and the hillsides, that it may be strong and nutritious throughout the year. We bless the flocks, the herds and the fish of the sea, that they may be well and strong, and that they may multiply. We bless the local schools, that they may be secure, safe places for teachers and pupils alike. We bless the children's capacity to learn and develop relationships, and we bless their simple trust in Jesus, that their trust may grow and become enriched. We speak to all the churches and chapels. We say we bless you in the name of the Lord, that the Holy Spirit and the Word of God may flow out of you in power. We bless the hearts of all people, that all may be convinced of the need of Jesus the Saviour and respond to the voice of the living God. We bless you that the overspill of blessings of the presence of the kingdom of God may fall upon you and keep you safe. And we give Jesus the praise and the thanks in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen.